Time at Northeast Conference Basketball in Fairfield, Connecticut. Fairleigh Dickinson with a 31-28 lead over Sacred Heart. Let's get a look at our halftime highlights, Joe, and it really has been Mustafa Jones with 10 points to lead the way.
Yeah, Mustafa's a scoring threat anytime he touches the ball. Here's one of his two threes going left. Knocks it in like he's been doing it his whole life. He's born to score. And it's also Davon Barnett making that 15-footer, which he's good at. Good assist by Gaetano. There's Towns taking what the defense gives him. No weak side help, so he's able to drive it in. There's the defense by Broom, who can play two position and is good on defense. Here's the nice little lift. Chris Robinson coming off the bench with two baskets, making 4 points. He's a freshman. He's going to be a good one. But the story has been the Fairleigh Dickinson defense turning 15 turnovers into easy baskets.
All right, tonight's halftime stats are brought to you by Snyder's of Hanover. Discover the pretzelabilities. And you see that turnover number, Joe, it's big.
Yeah, that's the big number. 15 turnovers by Sacred Heart, 10 easy points off of turnovers. Both of these teams struggle offensively, especially lately, if you will. So turnovers into quick points will certainly help.
And rebounding, certainly a problem for Coach Greg Horrenda's Knights. We'll see if they can crash the boards in the second half. Once again, we're at the break with Fairleigh Dickinson up by 3.
How did I win that new account? I started by making myself at home while I checked in with the office. And after grabbing breakfast, I got some last-minute advice from my boss. It made all the difference.
Great endings begin here. That's why at Choice Hotels, we give you cozy rooms, free breakfast, and right now up to 20% off when you book direct at choicehotels.com.
The world has changed, and Fairleigh Dickinson University is doing something about it.
The biggest thing FDU has to offer is their global education.
Undergrad, master's, doctorate, whatever it is that you're looking for, they have so many different opportunities for so many different interests.
We give opportunities for people to change the way they view themselves and their world.
It's given me a chance to succeed.
They've made my dream come true.
I love it. I would choose no other place.
Cannot speak more highly of this institution.
It's everything I expected it to be and more.
Go!
At Sacred Heart, we challenge the mind, the spirit, and the soul.
You will be encouraged to think, to grow,
and be good, ethical, solid citizens of the world.
Education isn't just about training, it's about transformation.
Defining your passion for what you really want to do in life and what you really love.
You're going to be a part of a culture in which intellectual curiosity is cool.
I can grow and become the person that I aspire to be.
We have state-of-the-art laboratories, classrooms.
We're doing things that matter.
Our graduates can change the world.
It's an exciting time to be part of Sacred Heart University.
The energy here is contagious.
The energy here is contagious.
You should come here because we're one great big family.
That makes you never want to leave and always want to come back.
That's Sacred Heart in its prime time. It's awesome.
And the next chapter is even more exciting.
The world has changed, and Fairleigh Dickinson University is doing something about it.
The biggest thing FDU has to offer is their global education.
Undergrad, master's, doctorate, whatever it is that you're looking for, they have so many different opportunities for so many different interests.
We give opportunities for people to change the way they view themselves and their world.
It's given me a chance to succeed.
They've made my dream come true.
I love it. I would choose no other place.
We're at halftime in Fairfield, where Fairleigh Dickinson leads Sacred Heart 31-28, and Pioneers head coach Anthony Latina standing by with our own Matt Harmon.
All right, Paul, thanks so much. Coach, obviously big advantage for you guys on the glass. How do you transfer that into some more success in the second half?
Well, I think our biggest problem right now is we're turning the ball over too much. You can't turn the ball over 15 times in a half and expect to be leading in a game. So we got to take better care of the ball. If we keep rebounding like that and turn it over less, we'll be in good shape.
Coach, appreciate the time. Best of luck.
Thank you.
All right, Matt, thank you so much. Joe, let's quickly get a look at the other scores around the NEC. And the Bryant Bulldogs are tied with St. Francis of Brooklyn for first place in the conference at 5-1. Actually, Brooklyn, I believe St. Francis won last night. They're 6-1, but that would be a bad loss for the Bulldogs.
That would be a big upset. LIU's on the young side. For them to go up to Bryant, win that game would be huge, but it's still early.
Look at some of the other scores. The Seahawks, they had a really nice win the other day against Fairleigh Dickinson.
Wagner's struggling on the road, though. They're 1-9 on the road. So if they're going to win in this conference, you got to win some games on the road.
And Robin Morris and Mount St. Mary's, that's turned into a great rivalry.
Absolutely has. And you know those two teams, no matter where they're picked, they're going to be in the top half, and they're going to contend for an NEC title.
Yeah, that's the kind of game that Vince McMahon would enjoy watching. Our next NEC telecast will be coming your way on many of these same stations. For example, Wagner in Central Connecticut on Saturday at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Check your local listings. Also on Saturday at 4 o'clock at St. Francis of Brooklyn hosting Robin Morris. That one will be on ESPN3. So NEC basketball coming your way in the comfort of your own living room.
And you've talked about it, Paul. Only the top eight teams make the playoffs, but also the top four get a home game.
Look at the leading scorers. Mustafa Jones atop the list with 10 points to lead everybody. Fairly with the basketball to start the half, and they're road Navy Blues, and the alley-oop does not work intended for Stokes.
Good job by Phil Gaetano. He recognized the play, got in the way. No basket for FDU.
Darian Anderson was a bit out of control, but the Pioneers bailed him out with a foul.
They absolutely do, and to be honest with you, I like, obviously, Latina's observations at halftime, talking about the turnovers and the rebounds. They're quite lucky, Paul, to have 15 turnovers and be only down three.
Philippe Nowitzki picks up his first, and to the foul line, it's Darian Anderson now of 4 of 4 from the stripe tonight. He's got 9, as you saw Pioneers coach Latina looking on.
And expect some type of press after a made free throw. If Sacred Heart's ready, they should get it in, get it up the court, and get a quick basket.
Anderson in and out. And the Pioneers come back the other way off the Barnett rebound. Quickly up the floor. Look at that push. Stokes with the block, but the foul as Kelly went up strong.
And that's where Kelly excels. He gets the ball in transition, his head's up. He's a great athlete. There's the pass ahead. He draws the contact. Double punch. You know what? It would have been a good, clean play if Stokes didn't swat at the ball. But he reached down. And even in, hey, Paul, even when it's not a foul, when you reach or swat down, it looks like a foul.
Second personal on Stokes. Kelly will get another. Now 0 of 2 from the line tonight at 61% on the season. You saw Coach Greg Orenda just a short moment ago, clearly upset at allowing the Pioneers to get out in transition.
Well, when you scout Sacred Heart, you know that on any missed shot, the outlet's going to go Gaetano, and he's looking up the right or the left side.
McDonald in the corner for three.
And Greg Horrenda's got to be ecstatic that McDonald knocked that shot in. He's been struggling of late.
His second triple of the night. He's got 6, averaging 9 points per ball game. The dribble drive, and Broom will go to the line.
Yeah, what McDonald likes to do is get down the court, set up in that corner. He's got his feet set. Good follow through, great backspin, nothing but the bottom of the net.
Remember when Dollar Bill Bradley used to do that?
He actually looks like Dollar Bill a little bit there.
Foul goes on Mustafa Jones, his second, and the team's first. Broom now with 5 points on the night. 3 of 3 from the line.
And our young viewers are going, who? Dollar Bill, Willis Reed, Dave DeBusschere, Clyde Frazier, Dick Barnett. I wasn't even a Knick fan. I was an Oscar Robertson fan. He was my idol.
Well, they might know that Bill Bradley was a senator from New Jersey at one point.
Yeah, but Oscar Robertson averaged a triple-double. They didn't even talk about that back in the day.
Mustafa Jones, the bucket and the foul. A move out of the book of Earl the Pearl Monroe.
Yeah, absolutely. Here it is. Draws the contact, fade away. Good concentration as the FDU bench erupts.
Evan Kelly picks up his first, the team's second, and Jones to the line looking for the three-point play. He has 12. Make it 13.
Yeah, Horrenda with the bear hug shows his emotion. Right now, Sacred Heart's got to handle his press. The 15 turnovers in the first half were not a good sign.
Fairly with our largest lead by either team tonight, up by 7. This is Nowitzki and a traveling call.
Yeah, it's a good call. He hesitated. He dragged his foot. You got to catch it and finish it. Go up strong. Get the basket or draw the foul.
Maybe he'll learn that. He's only a freshman right now coming by way of Poland.
He only averages 12 minutes also, so he seems a little rusty.
Mustafa Jones amongst the trees takes a hard spill. 26 to shoot. Fairly maintains possession. Mustafa Jones 6'3", 180. I would say wiry might be a good way to describe him.
Yeah, he's wiry, strong. He's a basketball player from Philly. He knows how to play, and he's born to score. You have to know, if you're Sacred Heart, you have to have five sets of eyes on him when he has the ball.
Jones had 22 points earlier this year in the win over Princeton. He drives to the basket here and draws the two-shot foul.
Yeah, the drive was too easy right now. He drove it right. There was good help. It's a little late, and the foul's on the big guy. There's Nowicki right there. There was some contact. It's a good call.
Jones, 3 of 3 from the line tonight, looking to expand Fairleigh's 7-point lead. 14 points for Mustafa Jones.
And we talked about this young man's automatic from the foul line. So right now, again, Sacred Heart's got to know that a press is coming. If they get it out quick, get it up the court, maybe they can get an easy hoop.
15 for Jones, and Fairleigh is on top, 40-31. Kelly pushes. Gaetano, Broom, nice move.
And a great cross-court pass by Gaetano. The ball was pushed, it was moved around, every player on the perimeter touched it. A cross-court pass, a little shot fake, and a dribble drive by Broom.
8 points for Broom. Nearly lost the handle, it was Anderson. Gets some help from Stokes, 15 seconds to shoot. There's the crossover. Earl Potts for three. Nice rebound for Anderson as he gets in there to mix it up, and then he's called for walking. Let's get a look here, Joe.
Yeah, here's Kelly. He's pushing. He kicks it. The ball's reversed. An extra pass. Draws the defense. There's a skip. Oh, a little shot fake. And he's good with his body control.
Like Gumby. So athletic.
You got viewers who are going, who? We know what you did on Saturday mornings. Sit home and watch cartoons all morning.
There's Evan Kelly sticking a J.
High arcing.
Seven.
High arcing step back. There's another young man who doesn't shoot the ball particularly well beyond three, but he's a scorer. He'll find ways to get baskets.
Mustafa Jones got Kelly up in the air, but then he pulled it back. McDonald, the bounce pass for Stokes. They get back outside for McDonald. 15 to shoot. Here's Jones against Kelly. Takes him off the dribble. Nix pulls up from the foul line. Rebounded by Nowitzki. And Broom collides with Nix. Foul on Fairleigh Dickinson for Nix's first and the team's third.
You know, when Gaetano's in there handling the ball and he's at the head of a break, he usually makes the good pass. Now you got Broom, you add him to this backcourt. When he gets it ahead of the field, he's just so hard to defend. He's usually going to come away with a basket or a foul.
Fairleigh led by as many as 7 in our largest margin of the night. Right now they are up by 5. 3 minutes gone by in the second half. Paul Dottino, Joe DeSantis, and Matt Harmon with you on Northeast Conference Basketball. Gaetano for 3, his second triple of the night. He has 6.
And Fairleigh that time switched to his zone. Sacred Heart recognized it. They hit the short corner. That little spot between the block and the corner, and a nice skip pass, Gaetano for 3.
And FDU head coach Greg Kuranda calls for time, and he knows you can't give Gaetano that much room.
Well, here's the possession. It goes to the short corner. The best way to beat a zone is to skip it. Gaetano sets up, and when he gets his feet set, see the defense is drawn to the ball side, a great skip pass, and he knocks it in. That's a good answer for the senior guard.
40-38, Fairleigh Dickinson by 2. Now these two teams, as we talked about coming in, have lost 4-0 apiece. They're both scrapping, and I got a hunch this one may go down to the final couple of minutes, Joe, because they both understand the importance of fighting it out in conference play.
Yeah, you're talking about a team, Fairleigh Dickinson, that's 2-4 in the league, and Sacred Heart that's 1-5. They've had some close calls, as we talked about. They think they're better than their record, so they're going to fight, and they're going to try and win this game. I agree with you. I think it's going to be a close high-scoring game.
And, of course, that may also mean it comes down to free throws, and that's been a bugaboo for Coach Latina and the Pioneers all season long.
You're right. Advantage Fairleigh Dickinson if it comes down to free throws.
All right, folks, stick around with us. We got a real good one here on NEC Basketball. And, you know, one of the funny parts about it is when you talk about this conference and the fact that only 8 of the 10 teams make it, Joe, you remember the days when everybody made it. Now you got to worry about falling down in the basement because you get squeezed out.
Let me tell you something. These coaches watch the standings every night.
They sure do.
You know, and it's a scary thing if you're a coach in this league because your goal as an administration, as an athletic department, is to get your team exposure by getting them in the playoffs. You don't get them in the playoffs, it's going to be that's a strike against you in terms of your coaching career.
All right, let's get a look at the standings here in the Northeast Conference once again. We showed them to you earlier tonight. And Bryant is involved in a very difficult game with LIU right now. And as I mentioned, half a game behind St. Francis of Brooklyn. The Chariots beat Central Connecticut at Madison Square Garden last night to move into first place.
And you got to like St. Francis of Brooklyn, of Pennsylvania, who now goes by St. Francis University. Rob Krimmel's done a good job resurrecting that program.
Yeah, both St. Francis clubs doing well. McDonald on the dribble drive will go to the line for two. His first trip to the stripe tonight. The sophomore out of Buffalo at 85% from the line this year. And we get a look at those out-of-town scores. Bryant involved in a dogfight with LIU. Wagner at home with an advantage over the Red Flash. McDonald now with 7 points as we continue to look at the scoreboard. The Mount and Robert Morris, that one's going to go down to the wire. You just know it will. 41-38, Fairleigh Dickinson. McDonald connects on both ends, and he's got himself 8.
And here's the FDU press. There's the trap. If Sacred Hawk can break out of it, they can get an easy look.
And Broome slows things down. A wise decision by the freshman. Here comes Kelly. Barnett. Sticks it.
You know, we don't talk a lot about Davon Barnett. Here's a guy who made all-rookie team last year. He's a solid player. He doesn't do it flashy. He just rebounds, and he makes that 15-footer.
Had 21 the other night in the 20-point loss to Robert Morris, averaging 11.5 on the season. Davon Barnett. Off the double team. Barely having some trouble. Xavier Harris, I saw some elbows flying, but Fairleigh gets timeout.
Yeah, good job by Kane Bruni. Came over and he trapped Xavier Harris, and Xavier Harris was stuck with the ball, so good timeout. You know, I see a lot of times these days, good traps are negated by players reaching and trying to get steals. When you got a good trap, keep your hand straight up, don't foul, because you have an advantage right now.
And so many times, you know, you hear coaches talk about it, you even hear announcers talk about it, but players forget when they're on the floor that the sideline is truly their extra teammate.
That's right. So that we call that area in the corner is called the Crawford Corner. And you look at Herenda right there. Again, he's diagramming probably an offensive play from out of bounds. But that area in the corner is called the Crawford Corner because you got two defenders. You got the baseline that acts as a defender and the sideline. So you really got nowhere to go. Here's the entry pass. Harris gets it off the post. Broome leaves his man, and there's the trap.
And he's got nowhere to go.
So you burn a timeout, and the FDU does, and it may hurt them down the stretch.
They will have two remaining. Fairleigh Dickinson with the ball and a two-point lead, 15 seconds to shoot. Anderson gets it into the backcourt for Mustafa Jones. McDonald, Potts, and Xavier Harris also on the floor. There is Harris in the paint with a strong move, his second bucket for 4.
And out of the timeout, a high ball screen, big little screen, nice pick and roll.
Broome tries to answer with a quick drive. Harris has the rebound and Fairleigh will push. Anderson, the alley-oop for Potts, deflected away by Kelly. And Sacred Heart comes back the other way. Gaetano for 3. McDonald the board.
It's a good possession because they pushed it and they made the extra pass. I would have liked to have seen the ball reverse to this side and maybe break down a defender when he's vulnerable in a dribble drive situation.
Here's Potts. It'll be Fairleigh ball. Last touched, I believe, by Davon Barnett.
Here's Day-Day Barnett. Nice little extra pass by Kelly. Nice little 15-footer. And here's the old-fashioned pick and roll. Fairleigh Dickinson by 4.
NEC Front Row is the official online digital network of the Northeast Conference. With live HD webcasts, highlight packages, and full game archives, the state-of-the-art site is your one-stop shop for everything NEC. Best of all, NEC Front Row content is free. Whether at home or viewing on your mobile device, enjoy the best seat in the house at NECFrontRow.com.
NEC Front Row is free. If it's free, it's me. And let me tell you something. When I was a college coach, at any level, as assistant or head coach, I used to watch a ton of film. Now, as I prepare for these NEC contests, I love clicking on NEC Front Row. Great production, great opportunity to see the teams you're going to play. Great job, NEC Front Row. Catch it.
Good stuff. Paul Dottino along with Joe DeSantis and Matt Harmon with you in Fairfield, Connecticut. Fairleigh Dickinson with a four-point lead.
You know, we just got a shot at Anthony Dottino with 25 minutes into the game, and we haven't mentioned his former boss, Dave Bike. Talk about him.
Legendary Dave Bike. We'll get to that in just a second as Potts drives and comes up short. The rebound by Barnett. And immediately the Pioneers will push. Here is Evan Kelly. Doesn't get it. Rebound to Potts. And Fairleigh will push it back. Anderson wanted McDonald on the pass, and they simply misfired.
It's a good idea, but obviously not a well-executed pass. And too bad for Evan Kelly. I thought that was a great stutter move. There's Coach Arenda talking to his staff right there. But I thought Evan Kelly executed a very much under-controlled stutter and go. Just couldn't get the roll.
Yeah, you talked about earlier how Dave Bike was the man here at Sacred Heart for decades upon decades. Anthony Latina was his assistant for 6 years and took over last season.
Great guy, great coach. I understand he's down in Florida. Good for him. Probably working on that tan.
Smart man. Short shot, no good by Barnett, but the rebound by Glowiak as the Pioneers get a new shot clock.
11th offensive rebound for Sacred Heart.
Off glass, Glowiak with his second basket. He has five, and it's a 44-42 Fairleigh lead.
Yeah, Glowiak showing some athleticism towards the rim. We know him as a standstill shooter, but he's a strong guard. He's got a nose for the rim. That's a nice shot by Steve Glowiak.
Knicks for McDonald. Harris, Jones, and Potts on the floor for Fairleigh. Knicks is picked up by Glowiak. Barnett, Allen, Kelly, and Broom on the floor for the Pioneers. Under 10 to shoot, Mustafa Jones, too strong for three. Kelly skies for the board. Sacred Heart with at least a chance to tie. 6.5 minutes gone by in the second half. And the reach in by Potts. That is his second. And the team's fourth. McDonald to the bench, replaced by Marcus Towns for Fairleigh. McDonald leaves with 8-5 coming in the second half. Broom leaves it for Barnett. In the corner, that's Kelly's three. And Sacred Heart has a one-point lead.
Yeah, with Kane Broome now at the point guard, he got a ball screen. So once a player of that stature who can score gets the ball screen, the defense shifts. He kicks it to Barnett. Barnett with the extra pass. Kelly with the nice three.
Harris kicks it out for Mustafa Jones. Straight on. Short. Tipped up and controlled by Glowiak. It's a three-on-two. Glowiak right to the rim.
The senior, the fifth-year senior guard, looked off Kelly in the corner, drove it high above the rim, laid it in.
He has seven, and so Sacred Heart's got a three-point lead. Chance of defense from this Pioneers home crowd. Dribble drive by Knicks and a foul.
You know, you talk about Glowiak being a possible 1,000-point scorer. Here's the ball screen. Notice the attention he attracted. Extra pass by Barnett. And here's Glowiak, head up, under control, little crossover, lays it in. But how about bringing a kid like Glowiak off the bench? Going to be a 1,000-point scorer. Right now, he's contributing to this game, and he's been an impact, and I believe he's got 7 points.
He does. Broom picked up his second personal. No one has three in this game, and there's a walking call on Xavier Harris. And so the momentum is now switched to Sacred Heart.
Well, what's happening now is Sacred Heart has picked up their defense, and they're getting some easy looks in transition. But, Paul, they're taking care of the basketball. They had 15 turnovers in the first half. They have one in 8 minutes of play. Well, there's number two.
And Jenkins comes back the other way for Fairley. Mustafa Jones to the basket. Tipped up by Harris, and let's see. They'll say that Barnett stepped on the baseline as he corralled the basketball.
Well, fortunately for Sacred Heart, the turnover did not turn into an easy basket. Unfortunately, it's still FDU's ball, so they still got a chance to capitalize.
The new 35 for Fairley. Jones guarded by Kelly, and that's a heck of an assignment, isn't it? Jones for three. The rebound to Broome. And for being such a wiry guy, Broome averages over four boards a game.
Well, you know what? Guards are more involved in rebounds now because a lot of three-point shots are being taken. Long shots, long rebounds.
Kelly tips it back out to Glowiak. What a play by the Pioneers. Off glass, tipped up and in. Xavier Harris tips it into his own basket.
Well, they're going to give it to Jordan Allen because he was closer to the basket. But right now, Sacred Heart is the aggressor on offense, and they have a five-point lead.
For Allen, his first 2 points, well, not really, of the night. Towns up top, guarded by Barnett. 12 seconds to shoot. This is Xavier Harris. Towns. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Off the crossover, to the rack. His third field goal for six.
Another great move from the perimeter. Right to left, changing speed, changing direction, finishing at the rim.
And back and forth we go as the Knights cut it to three. Broome through traffic. Fouled by Harris, who picks up his third.
The ball screen, Paul, has become such a big part of the game. That time, Kane Broome rejected the ball screen, didn't use it. But here's the tip-in. Let's watch it. It was tapped in by FDU, but Jordan Allen gets the easiest basket probably of his career. And here's the reverse. Nice finish. Sacred Heart now has a three-point lead.
To those who sleep, only to dream of getting back out. To those whose ambition fuels them to run further, jump higher, and train harder. To those who see beyond the game, beyond the crowd, the win, and the glory. Fostering a future that stretches beyond the playing field into the classroom, as well as the community. This is more than a sport. It's a way of life. A passion, a calling, a challenge. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. This is NEC Pride 365.
For information on how you can save 15% on your next stay at any Choice Hotel property nationwide, simply visit the NEC's website at northeastconference.org and click on the Corporate Partners link to learn more. Paul Dottino, Joe DeSantis, and Matt Harmon with you. It's a 49-46 second half lead for Sacred Heart over Fairley Dickinson. And Matt's standing by with a very special guest.
Paul, thanks so much. Very familiar face taking in some Thursday night basketball, NEC style. Executive Director of Athletics here at Sacred Heart, Bobby Valentine. First of all, Bobby, you know, off court, we talked about Phil Gaetano and his kind of academic story, but he's not it. Jordan Allen's going to have his master's by the time his career's done. Sean Bell, running back on the football team, FCS All-American, all part of that student-athlete mission.
Yeah, it's a mission of 800 student-athletes here. You know, last year we finished with a 3.29 GPA. For the entire group, and this year they're trying to top that. So, you know, we're not only doing it on the field and on the court, we're doing it out there in the classroom too. I'm really proud of these guys and gals.
When you think about it, such a buzz coming back here in the fall, football team making the FCS playoffs for the second consecutive year, finish the year ranked, that's really a great way to start the athletic season.
Yeah, to top that top 25, you know, second year in a row that we win the NEC, and you know, we're building pride, but we're also building spirit. You know, we have our ladies basketball team here tonight rooting on our guys. We have our volleyball team rooting on the basketball team, and you know, for 32 Division I sports, we have something really special going on here.
You know, when I pulled in the parking lot, I've been here so many times, was so impressed with all the building taking place, new dorm going up, and what could be kind of the crown jewel of the university, brand new business and communication center.
Yeah, business and communication. We're going to draw from all over the country to fill that building up, but we're also building athletic facilities. So for a mid-major, we're one of the few mid-majors that are actually expanding our enrollment, expanding our facilities, and I'm really proud of what the president and the entire staff has done here. Proud to be part of it.
Bobby, one more before we let you go. You've been not just a spectator tonight, but kind of an enthusiastic spectator. Used to get after the umpires every once in a while. Quick word for the referees.
Every once in a while, they'll hear my voice, or hopefully my players will, and they'll be inspired by it.
Thanks so much. Appreciate the time.
Yeah, Matt, thank you.
Paul, it's Bobby Valentine, executive director here in his second full year overseeing the program at Sacred Heart.
Always good to see Bobby V. Kane Broom with the slam-a-jamma, the only basket while Bobby was talking to Matt, and it's a five-point Pioneers edge.
Yeah, unusual to see Kane Broom, who shoots 70% from the foul line, missed two, but he was able to get a dunk after the good Sacred Heart defense forced the turnover.
Robinson, the rebound off the McDonald miss from three. And the Pioneers getting a three from Glowiak. He has 10, and what a bomb.
Glowiak, again, coming off the bench, making a difference. Got the handoff, barely had the ball in his hand. Pogo sticked way up and knocked it in.
The eight-point lead by the Pioneers, the largest by either team tonight. The possession arrow favors Sacred Heart here on this tie-up.
And this, you're not able to make this shot unless you practice, and practice. Here's the handoff, a catch and shoot. He's about 3 feet beyond the three.
Darian Anderson had a hand in his face.
That's what I'm saying. It's great shooters make shots, but they also make contested shots because they maintain their forms and fundamentals.
One thing Sacred Heart has to worry about, they're 9 of 14 from the line tonight. It has been a problem, and as you try to hold on to a late second half lead, you've got to hit your free throws. Off glass, don't worry about the foul line there. Chris Robinson has 6.
And the freshman from the Bronx flashed from right to left, caught it in traffic, and bounced it in.
Well, Anderson up under and through. He has 11.
Boy, we're seeing some athletic plays in this game.
Going for the steal was Mustafa Jones. Glowiak instead runs it into the forecourt. There's the scoop by Robinson, and he'll go to the line for 2.
And you saw in that possession the unselfishness of Sacred Heart. Glowiak could have made the shot, could have taken the shot. Allen got the ball off the pass. He could have taken it. He waited. He saw Robinson. Here's what I'm talking about. Glowiak right now can stop and pop. Allen can force it, but he sees his teammate, the freshman Robinson. Nice extra pass.
All right, so for Darian Anderson, his first personal, 16 foul on Fairleigh Dickinson. So Chris Robinson will go to the line for 2. Now he's only 3 of 6. From the stripe this season. In terms of foul difficulties, Xavier Harris has 3 for Fairleigh. No one else has more than 2 on either team.
Yeah, Robinson, I bet if we searched his high school records, he's probably a very good free throw shooter. He's got excellent form, just have not had a lot of attempts. There he makes the first. You know, as we mentioned, played at Cardinal Hayes in the Bronx, a line drive away from Yankee Stadium, if you will. Plays with an excellent coach down there in Joe Lodes. And as we said, he's going to be a good one. When he gets his opportunity next year to play extended minutes, I think he's going to eventually become one of the better players in the NEC.
Gets 1 of 2. The back tap goes to Glowiak. Down low, it's Barnett. He has 10. And we have our first double-digit margin of the night.
And credit the offensive rebound at Sacred Heart. Getting another possession, Barnett capitalizes.
They doubled up fairly off the boards in the first half. It's no surprise, Joe.
Well, you heard Latina at halftime. If they continue to rebound and they take care of the ball, they'll have a good shot of winning. They have an 11-point lead.
Mustafa Jones working off that pick from Stokes. Picked up by Glowiak, 10 seconds to shoot. So Jones fires an NBA 3. Charging for the board was Anderson, but it's run down by Robinson.
Boy, I don't like that shot. You know, there are ways you can get back into the game, and one of them is taking the three. The other one is getting to the rim, drawing the foul. Get to the foul line with the clock stop.
Still with only about 8 minutes to go, why not continue to drive and go for 2? This foul is going to be on the Pioneers. Take it back the other way. And a quick timeout as well. With 7:49 to play, Fairleigh Dickinson and Sacred Heart are in a good one. The Pioneers are on top by 11. It is a beautiful night for basketball, a beautiful night for football, a beautiful night for anything. But we're glad you could join us here on Northeast Conference Basketball. Sacred Heart with a second half lead over Fairleigh Dickinson, 59-48. And it's time to look at tonight's W.B. Mason delivery of the game.
Well, it's Gaetano always with his head up. A nice basketball cut and finish by Robinson. But the story in the first half was the turnovers by Sacred Heart. The story in the second half is taking care of the ball. Six assists, three turnovers in the second half.
W.B. Mason offers furniture and supplies. You can't go wrong when you buy right at W.B. Mason. Leading scorers in tonight's game, Mustafa Jones has 15 for Fairleigh. Darian Anderson has 11 as well. On the other side of the ledger, Sacred Heart has four guys with 10 points apiece. Broom, Kelly, Barnett, and Glowiak.
Yeah, and they're one of two NEC teams that have three players in double figures. That's because they have unselfish players. And Gaetano, we talked about, is the third all-time leader in assists in the Northeast Conference. So he certainly knows how to distribute the ball.
Remember that guy from LIU, Jason Brickman? He's number one.
Oh, he was fun to watch.
Next to the basket, rejected by Barnett. Robinson, one on two, and a foul. He was out of control, but it'll be a blocking foul on Fairleigh. Goes against Darian Anderson, who picks up his second. And for Fairleigh, that's their seventh team foul.
Well, what Sacred Heart has done is they picked up their defense. Here's the drive. There's the help by Barnett. Okay? The long rebound, if you will. A one-on-one situation gets Robinson to the foul line.
Front end, no good. He will get another. Let's go to the sidelines and Matt Harmon.
Paul, just popped my head into that last timeout huddle for FDU. And obviously, Coach Arenda not happy at all with the way that his team is playing defense as Sacred Heart has come out scorching here in the second half. Preaching to his team, however, take it one possession at a time. Try to get it down to a workable margin going in to the next media timeout.
And the Pioneers are now 10 of 18 from the line. Robinson only one of four. McDonald. The three by Towns, too strong. Glowiak the rebound. And for Glowiak, that's his ninth board of the night.
Yeah, he's been a big, big help coming off that bench. Once again, an experienced 50-year senior making a difference in this contest.
Also chipping in with 10 points on the scoreboard. Sacred Heart with the ball and an 11-point lead. This is Gaetano with 10 seconds to shoot. Good defense by Fairleigh. Barnett rejected from behind by Stokes. Towns leaves it for Anderson, who has 13.
And Darius Stokes comes up big. Barnett looks like he had the open layup. The block shot, great execution of a two-on-one, easy layup.
For Fairleigh, that's their first block of the game. Stokes now with 18 on the season, came in tied for fifth in the NEC. Nice pass from Robinson for Allen. Has his own rebound and a traveling call.
Here's what we're talking about. Defense can create offense. Here's the nice dribble drive. It looks like an easy layup. Stokes kisses it off the glass. Towns, Anderson, easy too. Herenda needs more of that.
It's a 9-point game coming up on 6 minutes to play. Fairleigh led at the half, 31-28. But as you see, things have kind of changed since. Down low, jockeying for position. We got a foul on Allen as he was trying to guard Xavier Harris.
Harris does a good job of getting to his comfort zone. In other words, posting up deep in the lane. So all he has to do is catch, locate the defense, and go right or left.
For Allen, his second foul, the team's seventh. Harris, front end of the one and one, doesn't go short. He's only a 59% free throw shooter. McDonald with the three, has 11. And it's now a 59-53 ball game.
And here comes FDU. Good offensive rebound, extra pass. McDonald can knock in the three.
For McDonald, his third triple of the night. Ball is knocked away by Fairleigh, and McDonald gets the deuce off the steal by Milwaukee Knicks.
After the made basket, Fairleigh Dickinson sets up the press. They trap Gaetano, get the steal, and an excellent finish. Fairleigh Dickinson now has the momentum based on their defensive efforts.
And Sacred Heart calls for time. It is a four-point ball game.
And here's the extra pass. McDonald with his feet set, nothing but net. They set up the press. Knicks with the steal. A heck of a pass. And McDonald with the finish. Quick 5 points for the sophomore. FDU now down only four.
McDonald has 13, but 10 coming here in the second half. He averages 9 a game. He's a guy who can hit the three, and quite frankly, you don't see him mix it up down low all that often. They've got to spring him free with screens and good passes.
Yeah, well, he's a fundamental player. He's a young man coming out of high school who didn't have a scholarship offer. His dad, Mike McDonald, who was a longtime assistant and head coach at Canisius, now coaches at Damon College Division II school in Buffalo, had to convince an old friend, Greg Aranda, to take him. And he's been a great player for 2 years. Now, the issue here right now, there's Matt, the good-looking sophomore, but the issue right now, Fairleigh Dickinson is going to throw some type of press, okay? They've been going with a 1-2-1 aggressive trap. Maybe they'll switch up and go to a 2-2-1 and make it look soft. And as soon as the offensive player comes over half court, trap and rotate. Latina's got to make sure his team knows they can run the baseline, get it in, get it up, and look for a quick score. If not, run your stuff and get something inside.
And you see, every other game around the conference is as tight as this one tonight, Joe. Pioneer basketball coming up on 5.5 minutes to go. The pass into the fourth court for Barnett. He drives one on two. Rebounded by McDonald. Quickly, Knicks into the fourth court for Towns. And Fairleigh will set things up. Mustafa Jones has 15 points tonight, but only 5 here in the second half for FDU.
Expect some type of ball screen, dribble handoff, driving kick.
Knicks around Nowitzki. McDonald can shoot the three from the corner, but he's way short here. It's kicked around, and Broom picks it up off the floor.
You know, it's a good idea to get your hands and feet ready to shoot the quick shot. You've made a couple, but if you notice the defense is on you, shot, fake, drive, and make a play for your teammate.
Donald does shoot threes at 37%. That's 10th in the conference, so he's certainly confident enough to do it. Here we get a whistle on Fairleigh Dickinson. That'll be team foul number 8.
And you got the foul on Marcus Towns that time. He tried for the steal. That's his second foul. Again, you want to play aggressive, but you want to play smart, especially on the defensive end.
So that means the Pioneers will go back to the line, where they are 10 of 18 tonight. Front end of the 1-1 will be by Davon Barnett, who is 2 of 3 at 62% on the season. The sophomore knocks it down. He's got 11 points.
You know, he's like the silent assassin in there. Like I said, he's not flashy. He just gets the job done. Latina's happy. His team's finally making pressure free throws.
Barnett, a sophomore out of Waldorf, Maryland. 6'5", 193 pounds. Had 21 the other night against Robert Morris. Has 12 right now.
Actually, it's kind of a funky free throw. He's got a little hitch, but he knocked them both in. And that's a big answer, not only for the 2 points, but from the confidence standpoint of making free throws.
And so it's a 6-point Sacred Heart lead. But here comes Fairleigh Dickinson, the dribble drive by Towns and the rejection down low. I think Barnett's the one who got a piece of it.
I think it was the big fella Nowicki who got it. Either way, it was good help defense. You're in the right spot, big block. Let's see if Sacred Heart can run something and capitalize on the block shot.
Gaetano runs the show. Guarded tightly by Anderson, out by the timeline. 12 seconds to shoot. Gets the pick from Barnett. Loses control. The steal by the freshman Anderson for Marcus Towns. And a foul. And he hits the stanchion hard. Marcus Towns a bit shaken up. And they'll give him a minute to get himself together.
I tell you, sometimes you don't want to be a cameraman. You know, you got a great seat right there. But you better make sure that you're protected. There he is. Good for him.
Jeremy gives us the thumbs up. Good stuff, Jeremy. Thank you so much.
You know, you watch both of these teams play, especially Fairleigh Dickinson. When they get a steal after a good defensive possession, they almost kick it into a different gear, and they become fun to watch.
Third foul on Gaetano, 18th foul on the Pioneers. Towns to the line will get one more free throw. He's a 56% free throw shooter who has 6 points tonight. Defense! Fairley now 11 of 14 from the line. Has the second. 7 points for Marcus Towns, and it's a 61 to 56 ball game. Towns takes a quick seat on the bench. Potts back in for the Knights. Quick pass into the forecourt. There's Broom, and he'll slow it down again.
Again, it was the 1-2-1-1 press, but that time it was soft, meaning no traps. Good job by Sacred Heart recognizing. Now they'll slow it down and try and get a good shot.
Barnett around Potts, and there's the reach in. For Potts, that's his third and the team's ninth. So we'll get a timeout with 3:48 to play. And Sacred Heart on top by five. Back with more NEC basketball after this. Northeast Conference Basketball is brought to you by Choice Hotels International, the official hotel partner of the NEC. And by Bayer, science for a better life. With 3:48 to play, Sacred Heart has come from behind and leads Fairleigh Dickinson 61-46. And the Knights have not gotten all the balanced scoring that they're so used to having, Joe.
Well, I think they're fortunate that they're getting some scoring from their defense. They did in the first half. Sacred Heart, for the first 13 minutes of the second half, held, you know, did a good job of holding the ball, taking care of the ball. But the last 4 minutes, Sacred Heart has turned the ball over 3 times, which has resulted in 6 points for Fairleigh Dickinson. So I like the fact that they know they're not a great scoring team, so they're trying to create offense off their defense.
Davon Barnett hits the first free throw. He will now get another. He has 13 points. You get a look at Sacred Heart coach Anthony Latina. Earl Potts picked up his fourth foul right before that break. 14 points now for Barnett. And Coach Latina's team is on top by 6 with 3:45 to play. The dribble drive by Anderson. Oh, that's a pretty move. He has 15.
It's a pretty move because he went by 3 guys, right, left, and finished it with his right hand.
It is a 5-point game. Broom into the forecourt, picked up by Anderson. The battle of two terrific freshmen. Broom gives it off for Nowitzki, and he can't finish. But the rebound by Barnett to keep it alive.
And that's Sacred Heart's 15th offensive rebound. So give the Pioneers credit for following the shot, getting the offensive rebound.
Broom with a three! 13 for Kane Broom! And Sacred Heart is on top by 8.
Great players not only make great shots, but they make them at big times. That's a big basket for the freshman.
Anderson's miss, rebounded by Xavier Harris. He fights and fights and can't finish, but has another offensive rebound. Picks it up off the floor, and we've got a foul. Xavier Harris with some extra effort.
But you gotta love the poise of this freshman. Here's Broom, left to right, getting the ball screen, knocking it in.
The foul will be on Filip Nowitzki, his third personal, and the Pioneers ninth. So to the line is Xavier Harris. 0 of 1 tonight, 59% on the season. Too strong.
Paul, watching that possession by FDU and seeing how they hit the offensive glass, it reminds me of a drill I used to do when I was coaching at Quinnipiac. We called it cage drill. We put 3 guys in there and just anything goes. You can push, shove, and the first guy to score three basket wins.
I like it. Harris fails on both, and so the Knights having some trouble now at the free throw line, and that's costly because they're down by eight.
Now, an interesting now is you had 2.5 minutes to go. You got Gaetano on the bench. I don't think he's going to be on that bench for long because he can run the team. He also can make free throws.
And the quick timeout by Pioneers coach Anthony Latina. You talk about Gaetano. He is 12 of 13 from the line this year at 92%. Has not taken a trip to the stripe tonight.
Well, you know what I like about this timeout? And he's not getting Gaetano in. I haven't seen him report in. I like this timeout because I think Latina's telling his team, with 2:29 to go, if we can get a good offensive possession and score, we may put this game out of reach. I mean, it's still a lot of time, but he's telling you by using, you know, he only has two timeouts now. By using this timeout, this is a big possession.
You know, Joe, when you talk about Nowitzki, you're talking about basketball royalty now. There's a difference here between the Nowitzki on Sacred Heart and the NBA's Nowitzki, who comes from Germany. This one comes from Poland. I don't know, maybe at some point, the Leaf will develop into the bona fide scorer that Dirk is, but at the moment, he's not quite there.
Well, I'm a little disappointed that they took the graphic off, because I wanted you to pronounce that town in Poland.
Let's go to the sidelines and Matt Harmon.
Paul, you guys just talking about what Coach Latina would be discussing with his team in that huddle. Well, it's all about defense on one side, patience on offense on the other. With time obviously winding down, Pioneers feel like they're in a great position to win this basketball game. One and done, that's what he said defensively. Make sure FDU gets one shot and then gets out of there.
Under 5 seconds to shoot. Boom, he's got to be aware of the clock. It's stolen by Nix. He gets it to Harris against Kelly. And he'll go to the line for two. A bad foul by Kelly because it stops the clock. But I have to wonder, Joe, Phil Gaetano, the ball general, and the guy who leads the NEC in assists a game on the bench during that last Pioneer set.
Yeah, Gaetano hasn't given him much offensively. He's made a couple of shots, but I do expect him to get back in this game. But again, I think you got to credit the FDU defense. They picked it up to another level.
Xavier Harris, who missed two free throws moments ago, hits the first of two here. He's got five. Kelly picks up his second personal, 10th team foul on Sacred Heart. It is a 7-point Pioneers lead. Make it six. Harris now with 6 points on the night. 66-60. Sacred Heart with the ball and the edge. Here comes that fairly trap. Nearly stolen by Mustafa Jones. Kelly for Nowitzki down low, and the block by Nix from the backside on Barnett, but they'll call him for the foul.
Yeah, Nix is calling for the jump ball, and he did have his hand on top of the ball. The problem was he made contact with his lower body. There's the extra pass. There's the contact. That's a foul.
Nix got up there, huh? He's only 5'8".
Yeah, another good athlete.
That's his second and the team's 10th. And so to the line, Davon Barnett. It's the first, and 15 points.
And this is a time right now where both staffs are looking at their notes. FDU's looking at the poor free throw shooters. Who do you want to foul?
Barnett's 7 of 8 now,
well,
by
I'm
the
saying.
Way, at only 62% on the season.
Well, he's hot, so you want to get him the ball. Sacred Heart, on the other hand, they're going to make sure that they get the ball to their good foul shooters. And Barnett certainly has answered the bell tonight. And you jinxed him. Oh, no, you didn't.
Gets the roll. 16 points for Davon Barnett. Fairley is down by 8 with the ball. 1:45 to go. Mustafa Jones. They need quicker possessions,
absolutely,
Joe.
Absolutely, you read my mind. They need some going to the rim also.
Anderson with the drive forces the issue, and the Pioneers are called for the foul.
You know what? I think it comes down to a simple game. Why not spread the floor, let your good offensive players take them off the dribble?
So that would be Nowitzki's fourth. And Darian Anderson goes to the line. He is 4 of 5 for head coach Greg Horrenda tonight. He has 15 points. He will get one more.
Both teams with two timeouts. Possession arrows fairly Dickinson way. Free throw shooting is certainly going to be a factor down the stretch.
Anderson gets the second, so he's got 16. and we'll get a substitution. Here comes Gaetano for Nowitzki.
You know, and Gaetano has not had a good game. We expect a lot from him when he handles the ball. He's got 3 assists, 5 turnovers, but that doesn't matter. If he can make good plays in this last minute and a half, he's going to help.
Glowiak ahead of the field.
Like
off
that
the
one.
Pass from Gaetano.
Like that one. They ran a play. I didn't quite see it. They sprung Glowiak loose. Gaetano's terrific at the long pass.
Anderson the other way gets fouled by Broom, and that is his third. So Glowiak has 12. 9 coming here in the second half, and this is a big one.
Yeah, you caught the end of it. It's a home run. We call it the home run play, where you send everybody up, you send somebody along, kind of a misdirection. Gaetano sees the floor as well as anybody.
In football, we call that a touchdown. Anderson to the line. Has 17.
The difference is we don't have time to spike the under inflated or deflated ball.
And the roll, 18 for Anderson. And it is a 7-point Pioneers lead, pressure by the Knights. Under 120 to go. There's the front court pass, nice job by Glowiak. And then a traveling call on Broom. Tough break for Sacred Heart.
Yeah, you don't want to turn the ball over and give Fairleigh Dickinson an opportunity to get baskets. But here it is, Gaetano with the head up. It was a tough pass, and he dragged his toe. That's an excellent call, official right there. Let's see if the Knights can capitalize.
Down by 7. Mustafa Jones, an NBA 3, and he knocks it down.
It might have been contact on that play. Going to his left with a man on him, he knocked it in.
4-point game, and Broom turns it over. Fairleigh Dickinson will take control with 1 minute to go.
What a shot. Mustafa Jones, once again, going to his left. He's about 25 feet out with a man on him. He knocked it in. Fairleigh Dickinson, he's got some life.
Jones with 18 points. Anderson to trigger. For Xavier Harris and back to Mustafa Jones. Again, the Knights are down by 4. He works around Nowitzki, and there's the foul. Nowitzki is fouled out. That is his 5th with 53.3 seconds to play.
Here's the handoff. You know what? I lied. He was about 28 feet out. That's a heck of a shot. Not a good foul by Nowitzki. You know, they're trying to cut him off. On that ball screen situation, you're trying to show the big man and make him go back or even double team him. Nowitzki was a little late, and he committed the foul. It might have a little acting job, too, by Mustafa on that one.
Should I remind you that Coach Latina told us that 3 of his 5 conference losses this season have come on the final possession of the game?
Yeah, and 6 of his losses on the year have been by 3 points or less. So this would be a huge win for his team to show the poise and gain the victory.
Mustafa Jones to the line, 5 of 5 from the stripe tonight, 88% on the season, which is tops in the NEC. One more for Jones. Horrenda's team will likely press. They are down by 3.
And Sacred Heart has got to know that they're going to be trapped right here, as you mentioned. And Sacred Heart's got to beat the press, or they got to make sure that they're aware that they have 2 timeouts left in case they do get in trouble.
It's a 2-point game. Jones has 20. Here comes Broom into the forecourt, charges the rim. Layup, no good. Rebounded by Xavier Harris. And Fairleigh has a chance to tie or take the lead. Anderson, Mustafa Jones, knocked away by Kelly. Jones on the floor, gets it to Anderson, and we've got a whistle right here as Fairleigh Dickinson calls for time with 35.9 seconds to go.
I tell you what, Fairleigh's lucky that 3 didn't go, because that would have been a big-time disappointment having called a timeout. But I do like the call. The game got a little ragged. The possession got a little ragged. Why not call a timeout, set up a play, get your strengths involved, whether it's inside or whether it's Harris or Jones off the ball screen.
You see the reset on our scoreboard. Each team's in the double bonus. Fairleigh with 1 timeout remaining. Sacred Heart has 2, and the possession arrow favors Fairleigh Dickinson. And the turnover story has really burned.